Hi everyone, this is Wilder Taylor, and you can check out my channel on the link above. Today I'm going to be doing a voiceover for Aqualab's own foolproof method of water change for aquarium maintenance. Water change is the process of changing out the polluted water that is in the tank for clean water. This is different from what we know to be top-off water. Top-off water is slowly adding in pure water to make up for evaporation that happens in the tank over time. In order to maintain the original level of salinity or saltiness, as the water in the tank slowly evaporates, we use top-off water, which is basically adding in little by little a non-salt water mix to make up for the evaporation. Now, water change is different. Water change is changing in clean water for the polluted water in the tank. So, the saltiness of both the water in the tank and the new water needs to be the same. The only difference is changing it for clean water. The biggest difficulty we face in water change is replicating the exact salinity of the water tank. Because most people don't have professional tools and beacons to be able to do precise measurements at home, it can be extremely difficult to get the exact amount of salt right down to the very gram. So in this video, we're going to be introducing to you an alternative way to get the salinity just right by using a simple math equation without having to make exact physical measurements, which we probably don't have the tools to do anyway. This method was developed exclusively by Aqualab. The exact equation will be in the description below. Basically, this equation was developed by using a statistical concept called a weighted mean. I'm not going to go into all the mathematics here, but basically, because specific gravity is a physical quantity, using this method is also great for measuring salinity as well. So the very first step is to measure the salinity in the main display tank. I'm using here a refractometer by Milwaukee. It cost me about $100 on Amazon. This is an electronic digital device that uses the refraction of light. Light comes out of this small part right here, and by using the refraction angle, it determines the salinity or saltiness. I have used the hydrometer before, but now I switched to this method. I think most people use this method, but you should use whatever works for you and whatever is more comfortable to you. But most people say that the refraction method is more exact. Well, to be completely accurate, the most precise would be something called the conductor, but that's only for professionals and very pricey and kind of unnecessary for the everyday user. So basically, you put a couple of drops into the hole on the right and it measures the salinity for you. I've already went ahead and measured the salinity in my water tank and it was 1.025. So I'm going to go ahead and show you how this process works. So here I have two water tanks. On the left is some very salty water and on the right is pure non-salted water. Let me show you how to measure the salinity of this very salty water here. So you just take a little bit and drop some here and you press the button. It says 1.044. Don't do this just once. Try it out a few times to make sure it's right. I'm going to try it again. And it says 1.044. So I would say that this is working pretty well and is pretty accurate. Now I'm just putting in some regular water, non-salted water that is on the right. And it seems to be coming out just as it should, 1.00. I'm trying it again, and it might not come out perfect every time, but you want to keep trying to kind of get the average. And after multiple times of trying, you can tell that the device is working and that there are almost no errors. Now that you have a refractometer device that is working, number one, and number two, a bucket of super salty water, a lot saltier than the salinity of the original tank that we're trying to replicate. Number three, a bucket of completely pure non-salted water, and of course, a calculator. I'm going to show you how to make the equation. So here is how you calculate. The salinity in my original tank is 1.025. So you type in just the 25. The salt water is 1.044, so I divide 25 by 44. And this number shows the ratio of how you need to mix the 1.044 salt water with the 1.000 pure water in order to get the 1.025 salinity in the original tank. So for example, if I need 1 liter, I would have to mix 0.568 milliliters of the salt water, which was 1.044, and the rest of the liter would have to be pure water, and that's 1 minus 0.568, which would be 0.432. I hope you guys got that.
So now we're going to show you exactly what that looks like. So based on our calculations, we need about 500 milliliters of salt water for every 450 milliliters of pure water. So I'm going to put in my desired amount of salt water and pure water according to the ratio given by the calculations. And because this is a 500 milliliter beacon, I'm counting how many times I'm putting in each, the salt water and the pure water. In this way, I don't have to measure out the grains of salt in order to dilute it in the water, but I can just take a super salty mixture and pure water to get the desired amount of salinity just based on these calculations by calculating the ratio of which I need to mix the two together. And so I'm done with the salt water and I'm adding in the needed amount of the pure water. So I'm done roughly mixing it. Now I'm going to go ahead and measure the salinity of this mixture to make sure that it came out to 1.024 or 1.025, which is the desired salinity that I want, which is the salinity of my original tank. So I'm putting in a drop or two in there, and it says 1.024. You should do this a couple times to make sure that it's coming out right. I'm doing it again, pushing the button, and 1.024 again. So that means I need a little bit more salt water. So I'm going to add a little bit more. I'm just going to mix it up, trying it again. Again, maybe I should add a little bit more salt water. I think I added in too little. Now it says 1.023. So you just want to adjust accordingly and try it a few times to make sure it's working. Now after a few more mixes, I got 1.025, the salinity that I wanted. Now you need to try it a couple of times to get it right. It might not work the first time. And now that you have your desired ratio, you want to keep going at it until you get the right amount of this solution that you need. Now we're going to head over onto my tank and I'll show you how to get rid of the polluted water and exchange it for the new clean water that we have. So this is my tank, and first of all, you want to turn off all your motors that might interfere with this process. So I'm going to turn off the Voltec motor, and I'm going to also turn off the return motor. That's off, and I'm also going to turn off the top water system. Because I'm going to be putting in about 10 liters of this clear water, I want to take out about 10 liters also. So that would be 20 of these, because these are 500 milliliter beacons. So that's number 2. And that's number 3. I have a bucket down here. Number 4. Number 5. 6. 7. 8, 9, 10. So 10 more. 11, 12. 13, 14, 15.
2배속으로 하든지 그렇게.
16, 17.
어, 우리 너무 많네요. 뭐 딴 데다 버려야 되겠어. 18인가? 지금?
18번째입니다.
I think he's going over to the sink to throw it out in the sink because he ran out of room in the bucket below. So that was 18, and now it's 19 and 20. So we've taken out 10 liters of water, so you want to add in 10 liters of the clean water. And you want to do this very, very slowly as not to disturb the tank. You want to do this as slowly as possible. And now that it's all in, we can turn the motors back on. And it's ready to go. So thank you guys for watching, and we'll see you in the next video. Bye!
구동을 하겠습니다. 네, 슬러지들이 많이 빠졌죠.